Hi, I'm Vittoria. I'm a reptile keeper here at Naples Zoo. I have a four-year degree in wildlife and fisheries resource with a minor in conservation ecology. I started my journey when I was an intern here at Naples Zoo, and now I've been working here for about 3.5 years as a reptile keeper. Today, we're gonna show you our poison green and black dart frogs. So here with our frogs today, we actually just fed them, and something that we fed them were actually fruit flies. So fruit flies are perfect for them. It provides a good source of nutrients, but we also sprinkle some calcium powder on them for optimal nutrients. Now out in the wild, they're gonna be kind of eating those same things, but a little bit stronger with some other different insects, because that's actually how they get their toxins. So here at the zoo, since they're eating those fruit flies, they're actually not poisonous, so they're not harmful to us, like they would be out in the wild. Now you see those bright colors of the bright green, and that actually is to warn off their predators that they're poisonous. So they can be found over in Central and South America, where they'll be doing just this, foraging for some food. Now they're using their really great eyesight to locate some of those food items, and then their sticky tongues to grab them. You may notice when you're looking at them that their feet don't look very webbed, and that doesn't make them very good swimmers. So you'll never really find them in deep water. Now these animals are so important for our ecosystems for a couple of different reasons. They play those key components in our ecosystems, but they also act as an indicator species. Now what that means is they're on the front lines when it comes to the environment. They're letting us know if any problems are arising, because you're going to see it in the populations of frogs first. One of a major upset and decreasing populations of frogs are chytrid fungus. It makes a thick coat over their skin that really doesn't let them breathe all that well. So a lot of the populations are decreasing due to that fungus. But luckily, with the help of conservationists and zoos like Naples Zoo, we're helping work with our organizations to help these frogs not only come back, but then thrive out in the wild. Luckily for poison dart frogs, the black and green here, they're actually not endangered out in the wild. They have a pretty stable population, which is really good, not only for the frogs, but for us as well. Now, frogs are the first thing when it came to the animals that I loved the most. Frogs were always the ones that sparked my interest. And I was lucky enough to travel down to Panama earlier this year to check out the Panamanian golden frogs. They are actually extinct out in the wild due to that chytrid fungus. So being able to help with that project, thanks to Naples Zoo, it was really cool to actually put a dream of mine into reality. Thank you everyone for tuning in to our black and green dart frogs. We really hope you enjoyed this, and make sure to watch our future videos.